The resistor is the most fundamental part of an electric circuit. It is so important that it appears as part of the most fundamental formula, Ohm's law, and it is measured in ohms. It comes in different packages and can be as small as an SMD or as large as a power resistor. Today, we go through the different types and see how we can identify them without using a digital multimeter. Pretty easy. The resistor is a passive component with two terminals, and its purpose is to limit the current flow to a specific part of the electric circuit, and it can be identified with one of the following symbols. Unlike diodes or transistors, it doesn't matter which terminal goes where. So, what matters is the value and where you actually place it. For example, one of the classic electric circuits is the voltage divider, in which we can use just two resistors in series in order to control the output voltage. The carbon film resistor is used in applications where a good tolerance or high temperature coefficient is not the priority. This type of resistor is constructed out of a ceramic carrier with a thin pure carbon film around it. On the outer shell, there is a color code that indicates the value of the resistor more or less depending on their tolerance. The colored bands go from 3 up to 6. For the 3 or 4 bands here, the first two digits are the first two bands and the third band is the multiplier. The fourth band indicates the tolerance of the resistor. If you don't have it, then the tolerance is 20% by default. Crazy. For 5 or 6 band resistors like here, the third band becomes an additional digit, the fourth band is the multiplier, and the fifth one is the tolerance. In a 6 band resistor, you also get the temperature coefficient. Basically, it tells you how the value of the resistor changes correspond to a change of temperature. One important thing though is to make sure that you're holding the resistor properly while reading the bands from left to right. The separated or the metallic band should be on the right side. A similar resistor to the carbon film one is the metal film resistor. However, don't be fooled. This metal film resistor might look the same, but its properties for accuracy, stability, and reliability are much better, which is perfect for active filter or bridge circuits. So far, we've discussed resistors that are for pretty low power ratings, up to 1 or 2 watts. For high power applications, we often use wire-wound resistors. Those can reach to more than 1000 watts thanks to their special aluminum film design that gives it larger surface area to dissipate heat. If you want to know more about power ratings, you can check this video. But wire-wound resistors can be also made for high-precision applications such as calibrating equipment or audio frequency attenuators. The typical tolerance is about 0.1% and the temperature coefficient is about 5 ppm per Celsius. Another type of resistor is the SMD, right here. They are constructed from thin or thick film material in a very small package that sometimes is not easy to handle or soldered to the board with a typical soldering iron. Unlike through-hole resistors, those don't have bands on them. Instead, there are numbers that indicate its resistance. In three-digit code system, the first two digits are the value and the third one is the multiplier. In four-digit system, the first three digits are the resistant volume and the fourth one is the multiplier. For resistors that are smaller than 10 ohms, you will find letter R indicating the decimal point. But for your convenience, when you are ordering resistors from TMU website, you have parametric boots that make it easy to select the type, the resistance, power rating, and other features. If you want to know more, let us know in the comments, and if you like the video, make sure to check others on our channel. Mm-hmm. I behave like this with strangers too, so it's fine. We often use high power as this one.